The National Hockey League on Sportsnet presents the Stanley Cup Playoffs.
Incredible excitement and optimism surrounding the Vancouver Canucks, the most improved team in the NHL this year, a 26-point improvement on their way to their first Pacific Division title in more than a decade. The fans are out. They're ready to rock. It's the Canucks and the Predators at Rogers Arena. What a scene. Home team's a perfect 5-0 so far this postseason. Welcome in the Stanley Cup Playoffs presented by Rogers, and welcome in to our Sportsnet studios. Kevin Bieksa, the former Canuck, Elliot Friedman, and of course our special guest analyst Jake Allen, 11 years in the National Hockey League, and someone who's played with the other two Hughes brothers, right, in Luke and Jack, and now we get to see Quinn Hughes up to an incredible season, up to no good maybe tonight against the Predators.
Yeah, you know, and I think when you really look at it, he's the leader of that team, he's the captain. You know, he's come a long way. It's his first real playoff game in a real atmosphere at Rogers Arena. I played against them in the bubble. But, you know, playing with Luke and Jack this year, I just find Quinn's just such a mix of both of them. He's got Jack's elite offensive instinct, talent, quickness. You know, Luke's ability to, you know, skate the puck up the ice, a great first pass. And I don't think he gets enough credit for his defensive game as well. He logs huge minutes, but also he chips in offensively. He's, you know, he's a Norris Trophy candidate, if not the Norris Trophy winner this year. And he's a dynamic talent, and you don't find those too often, and what he brings for Vancouver is really important, and it's going to be a game changer for him.
But if you always look for things that say, okay, what did we learn in the meetings head-to-head? I think it's almost completely irrelevant based on where the Predators were at that point in the season.
Quinn Hughes is obviously the leader, the captain, but I think the emotional heartbeat of the team is JT Miller. And he'll play the exact same way in the playoffs that he played every regular season game. He's got the snarl. He's got the compete. He plays on the inside. He's in front of the net. He's whacking at pucks. He's super competitive. He'll finish his checks. You'll see him with the tablet 45 times tonight on the bench, directing traffic, telling everybody where to go. He'll talk to the coaches. He'll be before faceoffs telling guys where to go. He's just so engaged in the game, and he's having his best season. 103 points, led the team, plus 32, so obviously he's a guy. You'll probably see him against O'Reilly at times. O'Reilly's their shutdown guy. He's their shutdown guy. It'll be a great battle for him.
Second all-time playoff meeting between the Predators and the Canucks, and maybe, just maybe, it could be deja vu all over again, Kevin. We remember what happened last time they played.
This was a very underrated Nashville team, and it took us six games to beat them. And there's Shea Weber, Jake, your old teammate. He was a stud. Suter was in his prime. It was a big win for us to get by these guys, and it was a battle. It was a grind. It was physical. Once Vancouver does get to Nashville, they'll see what Bridgestone's all about, but that's a special atmosphere.
It's an unbelievable atmosphere to play in. I've got to play twice there. Just in the regular season alone, it's incredible. But you throw a playoff game into that building, and it is electric.
It's bonkers.
All right, so here is the scene at Rogers Arena. Of course, John Shorthouse, Dave Tomlinson will have the call. Dan Murphy is our ringside host. Enjoy period one, game one, Canucks and Preds. Soak in the scene.
This is our moment to welcome your Vancouver Canucks. Thank you.
Canucks fans have waited 9 long years for this. April 23rd, 2015, the last playoff game in this building. So that means the only playoff experience for most of Vancouver's young core came in Edmonton in 2020 in the bubble. And they were good. Quinn Hughes, Elias Pettersson in Edmonton leading the Canucks to a play-in win over the Wild and a series win over the Blues. And everybody remembers Thatcher, Bubble, Demko against Vegas nearly stole the series. He was brilliant, but the Canucks would ultimately fall in 7 games to Vegas. Nashville comes to town with plenty of grizzled playoff vets. So for the Predators, it's not about the bubble, it's about the sphere. Yes, it was not a beautiful day back on February the 15th. As Andrew Benet canceled the team event to go see U2 at the Sphere, and this was after an embarrassing 9-2 loss to the Dallas Stars. What would immediately follow, no one could have predicted. A hellacious run, 16-0-2. They would wrap up a playoff spot. So from the bubble to the Sphere, we come full circle to game 1 of this series. Shorthouse Thompson with a call, but not before the national anthems.